Everyone, this is David in the chat. Been quite a while since I last posted the video, but hey. So, with the re-release of that channel the same, I thought it would be fun to just go and show this around for new people. It's honestly these are always great games. So I have played every single one of these games before, so this is just mostly going to be me having fun, talk a bit about the game, and hopefully also mention a couple of changes that they did since they have indeed, as you could see with the difficulty selection, they have updated the older versions of this game. First of all, of course, the graphics, but the new graphics would have been a bit better. And one thing that I do like that they changed it to the way the unique form that the game had. I always have a particular name for these skills that I use. And I like to imagine just this skill being forged from different. I don't think it's quite the original idea of the name, but hey, I like the name. Ah, so yeah, the old classes and everything. I did notice when I looked through all of the games, like, before the recording and everything, they did change the... They do not keep this particular style, like, the red text is not in all of the games. It actually differs between games. Now then, let's see. This time. Yeah, they also added extra portraits for all of the various classes. Some of them I quite like, others not so much. But yeah. But one more thing that I noticed, of course, there's the DLC portraits. Hey, if you pre-order all the game, if you pre-ordered all the games, you would just get both of these at once. I believe they are also included if you get the bundle, but I'm not quite certain about that. Furthermore, which I also quite liked, you can actually choose any portrait regardless of class. They did this in Nexus, and having this return for about the older games is quite nice. It's quite nice, I think. I'm with this guy. This is gonna be Tulio. Then we are obviously going to run with... We're gonna run with Alchemists. Alchemists are quite fun. You know what, I tend to put myself into this as well. Oh, wait, that's not what I wanted. Oh well, I'm not quite used to the switch. Oh, there's Shadera's around. Let me just throw in... I do run with the survivors every so often, but I could run with the protector, and protector is always useful. Yeah. Let's just throw in one of the new ones. Uh, do look like a traveler. And we are going to run with a medic, of course. Now these names are not quite some. I just throw in some names like I. It's the first name I just comes up in me. I do want to run with a troubadour. Do I want to put a new one here? Nah. No, I could run with a new one. This is somewhat the one I always like. Yeah, we're gonna do you. You're going to be. What's a good name for you? You're lame. You're lame now. And that's it. Okay, that's something I did not realize. They apparently. So, I learned to notice they put the first one you make immediately in your party. So this is another thing that's. So, this is also something that later games tended to do. You could set your parties. And that way, if you had like multiple people around, you could just immediately call up parties. So you didn't have to fudge around with the formation every time. Furthermore, the renaming was also something that wasn't in the original, of course. There's the change of appearance, which wasn't in the original. Just a few nice little things, really. Yes. Good old Etria. Everybody likes this place. Well, maybe not everybody, but I quite like this place. This is a good place. The rooster in. So here's a little fun fact. That music is something that normally with the newer games you barely ever hear because the save mode is just that fast. In the older games, of course, you would have heard it quite a bit because it took a while to save and load the game. I like how they just made it as the save screen music. That actually helps people actually listen to it for a moment now. This is another one thing that the older versions had. Now, of course, good old Dr. Hoffman is still around here. Yeah, they even have his name now. I don't know, maybe they had the name before. I don't quite remember. Oh, I love how crisp the backgrounds are now. Like this is a good background. But yeah, they added. You can now just immediately skip to particular kinds of weapons. It used to be that everything was just in the alt tab and there was no other tabs.
So,
yeah, good on them. And also, of course, swapping characters used to be a bit difficult, a bit more difficult. Well, not quite that difficult, but it used to be a bit different. Right, for you, my friend, I want this thing. I'm also not quite certain if we start with more money or less money. You have what you need, you have what you need. Everybody else has what they need. Trevor, you are going to need the dodge. Let's see, you can have a dodge. As much as I know these games, defense isn't actually all that impressive. But, especially, like, for example, in Leaf Good Year, this is one of the most important things to actually get for a Earth Party. Because the extra agility helps so much. And of course, me, I'd always like to put the boots all the way in the bottom. Yeah, so in the other games, the accessories were so much better than everything else, but for me, I always like to keep my defenses up quite a bit. We're not going to do much with this place yet. But just to say hi to Valerie. I am going to be quite interested to see how they changed the quest, because that was always a bit of a problem with the first game. Everything else is just as I remember it. Here be dragons. Well, thankfully not until a very long time. And there's the map. So, I remember the... Well, I don't quite remember. The map making was one of the biggest reasons why I wanted to get these games. Because, well, this is definitely the selling point for these games. If the map making is not done correctly in the remakes, then the games will just not work nearly as well as they should. But as I can tell, with the controller layout, there's a lot of buttons that they can actually use. So what they used is apparently with the right thumbstick, you can move around. You can move the cursor around. And pick up things, of course. And with the left thumbstick, you can move the selection around. So as you can see, there's like the bigger map on the top, there's the smaller map on the bottom, the more focused in the map. So the L's and R just let you pick things. And of course, you can also choose any icons. Now, I do know that there is actually something over here. One other thing they did did. They added a lot of the icons that were not present in the originals. Okay. So that with the follow button, you can set the mini map on the bottom to follow where you actual characters are on the screen. So like the big green thing. And yeah, the one thing that's the you can also further zoom out if you'd like to see a bit more. I like to keep it around this size. This is a good size. There's different colors, which that you can use be the auto move is here. And of course you have every other of these. Now this one over here, this is a an icon that we won't be needing for this game. I'm also going to be interested to see if they added the dynamic icons, because there used to be dynamic icons in the later games. Yep, I did not. I did not use the skill points yet, and I see there's an undo button. Okay. Map making is a bit slower than what it used to be in the originals, of course, because hey, this is still the Switch. And I'm also playing it on basically on modern mode, so I'm just using my controller. I do know that the Switch has touchscreen, and I believe the entire map making is also touchscreen based. Of course, there is also the PC versions, and I believe that PC versions they even added mouse support. I do not have the PC versions, sadly, so I can't quite show you that to you. Well, they also really cleaned up this place. This used to be just a giant list of things that you can get. But now it's just a nice and simple nice and simple little thing. I do want to grab this. Cleaver is obviously not nearly a useful enough skill to actually use. I'm not quite fond of the poison ones. Like I don't use poison all that often in these games. And for you can start with just some fire skills. Also another one, I can skip over that, but you can actually level up multiple times if you have enough skill points. I do like how there's like these skills that are that all run off of the same base skill, but they require another skill early in the tree, and it just is this little loop. The skill tree is a lot more complicated than some of the other games, I will say that much. And there we go. Now then, off to go and explore a bit more. Okay, they also added a run option. And of course with NR you can sidestep. The cleanest tree rats you've ever seen. Because the gameplay is very old school. If you like dungeon crawlers, and especially if you just like mapping these places out yourself, these are definitely games that you want to pick up. I also like how the pop-in is not so much like whenever you go and go forward, you can tell. You can tell just what the game slowly loads in more places to actually look and more places to actually see. So there the map drawing controls. Yeah, might as well. So yeah. Okay, with plus you can also just immediately jump to the different icons, which is really useful. Full map of course is there, and well, you can also just pull the map off completely. Yep, so as it shows, you can use the touchscreen for this, you can also use the controller for this. Let's just go for the controller for now. So as I told you, like, this is something I was fudging around with while I was just standing around. So yeah, this is basically all that I've been talking about. Ah yes, this is also something new. Oh, and you can even set the controls. Okay, I did not know that one. That's neat. Very neat. Yeah, so yeah, there's auto mapping. If you don't like to draw your map, but you just like the game and you want to run around in it, then yep, you can just go around and have the auto map. We have to map the entire area of this. So I did hear him talk about this is something in all this. Animation speeds, alphabet speeds, alphabet confirmation. I'm going to turn this on because this is very useful. I'm going to turn this off. I'd like to play with that. So as you can see, whether the floors will be marked, the floors will not be marked, or if even the adjacent walls will be marked, I just keep that. I like to mark the walls myself. So yeah, you can also swap dominant hand, so if you are more left-handed, the entire controls probably will swap over to the other side, so you use the left-hand side to use to control the map, right-hand side to move. Quite useful. I don't quite know what this is about. Oh, I think this is the touch control settings. So how quickly the mapping cursor follows where you touch. In case you don't want to throw too much, want to place too much stuff. Can I? Okay, I can't. Okay. I like to do like this. I like the. And yeah, as you can see, there's the difficulty selection again on here. Should it be too difficult after you've started up the game, you can always select. You can always go back to. That goes over there. And you can always go back to an easier selection to easier difficulty. Okay. Very useful if you just want to keep the... I will say the mapping is a lot clunkier than in the original, but that's again because I'm using only controller. I imagine if you're using touchscreens it goes just as smoothly as all the other versions. I know what's in here. I'm not going to deal with this for now. I want more levels. Okay, so yeah, they do keep a small version of the map, but you can't really do anything with that, which is a little sad because sometimes I finish up drawing a map when I was drawing a map when the battle starts, and then just want to finish drawing. Oh well. I will say how smooth all this goes. This is very smooth. Oh no! So what Trevor just had just got us a. These icons are quite noticeable. So, the resistances, as you can tell, the weakness and resistance, those did not used to be part of the base game, the original game. So that's very nice to have them here. You can also tell like the buffs, debuffs, and any status. So in this case, Trevor has a headlight, which is honestly not a big deal for him. I do not like how they revert the how they change. Geo definitely needs something into this. How they take away your tool once battle starts. I kind of want to keep that. Careful, there is only one heal left, so... Yeah. I'm gonna have to say this, touchscreen controls will probably be a lot... I will definitely recommend to use the touchscreen controls for this. Or just get the PC version and play with the mouse, because hey, mouse is always superior to this. Mouse is always superior to touchscreens. Well, no, I'll take that back. Mouse and mouse screens, touch screens. It is great in a lot of ways, but not the touch, not for drawing. This is exactly the kind of battle I did not want to get into. Liam, don't die here. Very well done. There, Liam can stay around for just a little longer. I want to get to level 5 as quickly as possible with this. To do anything, but hey. Maybe I want to swap around my controls just a little. There's a couple of chests in here. Okay, they do have dynamic icons. Very good, very good. I definitely shouldn't be here any longer than I need to. Well, such is life. What's in here? Mega 2. Way more powerful than anything we need at the moment. Take a nap. The one failing though, you can't swap the map while walking. Alright. Pick up the idiot. So, in the original, wanted to sell multiple things at once, you could only sell the same kind at the same time. But now you can just sell everything you have. Do we want a dagger for the guy? why are you stronger? You're not supposed to be stronger. Puts us at evening, and that is exactly, well, at night time really, and that's exactly the time that I want to be at, because there's a nice little thing in this place. So a lot of people, some people actually think that being around at night is more dangerous than being around during the day, but that's actually not quite true. It is in some games, but not this one. In this one, if you just want to run around at night, nobody is going to look at you funny. Except for the monsters. Yeah, I'll look at that, so. Only at night. And there should be, yep, there it is. I know that's a little thing for later. Go a lot faster than in the original, which is actually quite nice. Like this game is relatively old. Relatively, I say, like in internet term. In internet terms, this game is quite ancient. It's always relaxing at the time. Nice music and everything. And yeah, I will just be going for however long I feel like. Again, with touchscreen, this would be a lot easier. That too is something for later. About that later. But now let's just. Are they anything to. Oh, the weak to ice! Of course,
moles. Moles are always weak to ice. Most of the moles are weak to ice, at least.
I actually never knew that. Neat.
Touchscreen is definitely going to be the preferred way to do this.
So of course in the original we did not have these unique icons, we had like one icon that we just had to put a memo on to note what it actually did. Or you just didn't care and we just put the icon on there.
Of the week to that with lightning.
See these, and that is something I do appreciate. In your team, so in this case Julio is the one who's going to interact with everything on the floors and everything and such, so if you don't want them to pick something up, do keep that in mind. In my case, I don't mind. You can take them. I do have to be a bit careful about how much magic I use, because that stuff is going to be very necessary in this little section. Now, the best part about this game is if you already know the map by heart, you can just completely skip the first mission by just drawing the entire map. In my case, I do know the maps, I do know a lot of little events, but I can't quite draw them right from memory. I don't even want to draw them from memory. I'm just being very lucky over there. And just like with the other event, I'm going to leave this one alone for a little bit. Because there's an event up there. I probably should have healed Clairs up again. Oh, I should have. I don't know if the heal was there because I could see her having some aims. Perhaps I was just going way too fast. Tornado is always useful. All Slash is a little bit better than Tornado, but I'm not really going to go for All Slash. I like the I'm going for these. Laser Freeze and Shocker. And that needs to be level 3. Now this. Attack of level 5? Ah, I don't remember that part. Oh well. It's not as if it is that big of a deal. And then we want to get some ice. That needs to be level 3. First thing we want to rush actually here is Salve. Salve is very strong, and after that we want Revive. Now then, so what's here? It's a boot. A size 10 boot. Probably. Not sure. So yeah, of course, there's always something, like, barely any event is purely good for you in this game.
Or style Moat back. Hold on.
And... oh, hey, yeah, we have a boost.
Boost is basically, you deal a lot more damage.
In the original it was that whatever you did had 5 more levels on it, so
5 or 10 more levels, it just vastly increased the actual effect of the thing.
Mainly because the first game was also mostly based around what your level was rather than your actual stats.
So if you did like a boost, you didn't
necessarily deal more damage all the time, but you would at the very least have a good chance of dealing a lot more damage. And that's some white stone. And that also means that I can now take this and. We have to do that. Yeah. We can just delete that. That's no longer necessary. And then. I think we're gonna just go and try. If we die, then we die. Such is life. I can guarantee at least one of us will die in this fight.
Kind of annoying because we kind of want refresh. We need to want refresh. But that's again for later. Of course, always the rats. The rats just don't want to stick around sometimes. I mean, for good measure, for good reason, but hey. Ah, there it is. This is the thing I do not... But when you find this thing, it's just look at it. There's legit no need to try and beat it to death with weapons. It takes way too long. You at full health. I don't want to try and risk that. And there can be a point. Alright, here goes. Yeah, why not? Let's take a bit of a rest. We've run through the entire night, so... yeah. So, most people don't die either... most people will die either to those three moles, because that's very early on if you just go in there and pick up the food and everything.
The rest of the people die here.
These are nasty, nasty enemies. Spare no expense. I'm gonna try and get rid of them as quickly as I can. And yeah, it's because of that poison. Luckily, we're not going to see what the poison actually does. Not for some time, please. There we go. I will say we were lucky. If that poison actually sticks, people will die. That's it. Normally with RPGs, status effects are not particularly impressive. In Etrian Odyssey and a couple of others, they are actually quite powerful. So, what are you actually using? Just all elements as expected. Let's continue, like, impervious physical harm, all the forms of protect are recommended.
Yeah.
There. But just in general, magic damage is incredibly potent in this game. A lot more potent than in some of the later ones. Yeah, now we can already move further, or we can just go back to the radar. I'm just gonna fill in this little part of the map. Consider it done for now. I'm gonna go see the radar again. And this is a white crystal. Clear crystal, I just always call it white. And yeah, I always color behind the doors and also these places, the stairs. Seeing these crisp sprites is just... It feels a bit weird, because I like the little grainy ones. The grainy sprites just make this... They give a bit of a charm to the game. Just a bit of charm. I got shit to sell! I got so much shit to sell. There you go. Hey, Fenway. Do I want the Fang Whip? Nah, I don't want the Fang Whip just yet. First, let me see. Well done, yeah. Announce 500 money and no experience. They have kept that same. Okay. So, what can you sell me now? Yeah.
So this used to be called the Warpwire. I like the Ariadne thread. I like just the reason why it's named that. Warpwire is also fun, but either or, really, either or. Now, I do want a couple of these. Next up, because we have finished the mission. Ah yes, I already sold all the soft hides that I got from the walls, but... Yeah, I'm just gonna speed through these. The quests are not particularly interesting, so... Well, then... It all depends. If they actually grant experience like they do in the newer games, then they're going to be interesting, but otherwise, they're not going to be that interesting. So yeah, the hand axe... there's the hardwood. The hardwood is something we can only get on the third floor, and... Or we have to take some chopping skills, and... I don't have chopping skills at the moment. I can take them up. Take up chopping skills. It's probably better if I take up chopping skills. But I don't think if I have any take skills in my party. Oh, you have mine. Oh no, you have take. Okay, cool. So I can actually chop if I want to. I can actually do all of them if I want to. Now then, we need to go and look for some water. Well, we already know where the water is. It's right up there. We're gonna have to beat a bunch of balls. Of course, Liam takes another punch because dodge what is dodging. Liam can stick with that magnet points and think for a while. Blind sight. They do go ahead and bind, but many of the ways in which you get ahead bind is made of some kind of constricting move. It's more like generally being distracted and such. Which also fits well with what a headbind actually does to people. Yeah, some honey water. Now let's see if we can go find a couple of moles. Specifically some soft hides. Straight up, damage and health numbers are rather low. I like to just see when people are going to be one-shotting things. Like, for example, this guy. This guy has 45 hit points. Well, this guy is a pretty bad example. Yeah, so like these have 19 hit points, so The moment any one of my front line can do 90 damage, like Tilio for example, he can just go up against one of them by himself. And that way you can just very easily go through large encounters, because you can just spread out all of your attacks without having to roll random blocks. Or again, or the impact crit, that also works, I suppose. Now then, moment of truth. There is some mysterious power in that stuff. Yeah, okay, no. Quests are still not interesting. Which does not inspire confidence for the second game, really. Because in the second... Oh, hold up. Because in the second game, they had the idea of having FOEs, which we're going to be seeing soon, not actually give any experience. So yeah, imagine that. You fight difficult fights and you don't even get any rewards for it. Of course, this guy has to stop us when we're nearly there. Ah, Julio, go look. Of course, the goddamn snakes. Snakes in the grass. Yep, now these little dudes are just all over the floor. And then we have poison. Let's hope I get energy. Alright, good. Very good. I am not going to stick around and show you guys what poison does. I do not want to do that. I will say I don't know if I am going to show the entire game on YouTube. At least, maybe not this one, maybe a later different one. Now I just wanted to get back to do some overtimes. How much it must be better than 3. This would be enough. No. But luckily no poison.
that moment when the mage kills you by just bonking him with just with a stick. Humiliation. I guess yeah, I can just play these games for hours and ends. These are good games. We have the fattest bunnies ever. They do not like to call fans. They really do not. And that goes to the end, unfortunately. Sucks. Now then. I believe this is just a medica. It's Soma. That is actually very worth the 100 N. So the weapon is, I believe it's a dagger or a broadsword. Which isn't a bad weapon, but for the price he asked you, he asked like I think 1,000 or something for it. It's just really not worth it. Pick up the idiot again. Don't mind. I kind of don't mind. Ow. Maybe. Come on. Ah yes. Oh yeah, he's does sell. This does be a short sword then. It's good, but it's not worth it. Defender is a very good skill to have. Put a point in gag. And we can go grab Sol for the next level. Out of my way. And that's the third for soft height. Nice. Was it 7 that we need? Seven. Yeah. Quests in this game are not preemptive here. Let me just show you how good physical attacks are. Not at all. Thank you. Middle of Bugmatura Expanse. That is some name.
Yep.
In Japan, they are apparently called just Field on Enemy, which is... Which works just as well for FOE, so... So yeah, as you can see, if you just keep a look at the little map in the corner there, at least then. Nah, but I'm not gonna risk it with the hair. Yeah, for every step you take, it takes one step too. So we want to be a bit careful about around it. Bunnies. We really need a few more levels because holy shit, am I taking damage? Might come in and leave right now. Thank you. Sanatorio. Stop eating everything you find. Old style of seeing FOEs. So, I know that there's an FOE like two steps in front of me, but I can't see it yet on the map because I haven't walked in that space yet. So, as long as you have walked within one square of that a certain space, you can see FOEs that might be there, but until you have done so, you cannot actually see them on the map, which is why this little skill here is actually quite useful at some point. So sight. You can't just sight to see the FOEs on the whole map, see all FOEs on the map, so you can see like higher level, lower for TP cost. I believe it's only for like the one step, so use it, you take note of all the FOEs, and then you carry on. That's basically how it works. It's not a particularly great skill, but this is this game and the other two, games of this pack, and the HD pack I will call it. It's actually a nice skill to have. Especially if you are just on a new floor and there's a bunch of police on it. Which is nowhere in the main game, I can tell you that much. It's practically nowhere in the main game will you actually need this. Yeah, you're not going to be seeing what these FOEs are just yet. Exploration of Etrian Odyssey is very much a case of resource management, I would say. And hit points are not really a resource in this. Sometimes hit points are, and you can easily survive with night one hit point left. But the majority of enemies will be taking that hit point if you try to live. If you try to run around with just a single point left. Well, eat the green fruit. So he's just eating everything. Wait, what are you guys achieving? Absolutely nothing. Which is expected because this is only game Etrian Odyssey 1.
I do not want to risk. Yeah, I'm not going to risk this. I see there's also valuables, which, hold on. Ah, sheepskin. I was wondering like what the map was made of, because you write so much on it, and... That's a sound effect that I think they could have done a bit better. Oh yeah, this is something that is only in this game, and I believe the second one as well, but Emeritas. Normally Emeritas are quite late in the game that you can actually get them, but right now you can just go buy, I suppose. They're very good items, 50 TP. That's 3 heals. So either I can buy like a single Medica, or I can just buy an Emerita for 3 heals, or maybe 3 extra magic casts and stuff. Arenas are good. They're good for long drawn-out fights. Medicas generally are not. Four soft fights. Still need 3 more. Doublet is for anybody but the Lanceknecht and Protector. I think I'm just gonna you kinda need it. Young Eyes, 4 fine, 5 fine. Oh boy. Volunteer Pup has... there's a couple of quests that are quite easy to just pick up and do, so... So for that one we have to go and do this. For up to 10 enemies. This Venom Fly is completely immune to status. I did not know that, and that's actually quite scary. Just this random enemy on the second floor immune to status ailments. Yep, sadly you do not get anything for this. So you just do it for yourself, really. I think I'll stop after like 2 hours. Seems like it's good. I say it's a good first episode, but damn. I don't think many people are going to watch that for 2 hours, but oh well. Might be fun to just put it up there and see. 25 damage to Teresa.
Yeah.
That's why we do one poison.
We do not like poison. Simple as.
There, level 7 sword mastery. Yeah, you can start working on defender. Kind of want to have a defender. You can grab shackles.
Yeah, so if you actually could get it with the amount of points that you have left, the game doesn't let you actually get it. Just auto invest points.
Yeah, solid.
Now we have a way to just pick up the entire party with only a single cast instead of having to spend TP on every single person that is that's injured. Oh, 4-3 red, that's fast. I think I will eventually start putting some points into the gathering skills. Also, I think game audio may be a bit loud compared to my voice. Fine, I suppose. Okay, this looks good scenes and everything. And there's a reason why some fans call it Banger Odyssey. Because it has good music. Now, I do know what is down here, and I do not want to go and fight it just yet. Oh hey, a fender! That's a new one. Hello, new one. Yeah, we're just a new one as in we haven't seen that one before. I'm gonna deal with the mold first. Actually, definitely protect the end there. This is basically how it generally goes, I suppose. Dark hunters are not at all good at surviving. Well, that's 135, I believe. No, 160 down the drain. Thank you, Liam. Oh, I only need a single soft height. Nice. Well, I suppose I'm gonna. So you may not die all that often, can kill things before they kill you. Yeah. There you can equip that. Trevor, you can take up the Supremacy Axe. Nappy. Extra saves are never a bad idea. Yeah, I'm just going to call it for a moment. When I get to the third floor, it shouldn't be taking that long. Actually, let's give him a nice note. Oh yeah, they're a weak against ice. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Yeah, that FOV right there, and a couple of bottles of the only ones that can see basically wherever they are. Two venom flies gone. This indeed, yep, it's indeed weak to lightning. I knew that much. I still don't know if they fixed the speeder issue, because speeder did not, they used to not do anything at all. Ignore. It hits like a truck, though. Come on, off the floor, Liam. Now it's Tilio. Nice. One by one, my frontline is just taking naps. I don't want to go back just yet. I have to. I can't go on without everybody getting experience like this. Up you go. I'm definitely gonna have to be a bit more careful with where I throw everybody. Which means I think for the next level I'm gonna pick up some gathering skills. And that's enough for fights. Well, we're not quite done yet. Yeah, so as you can very much tell from just how long the video is and everything. It's the game itself is also going to be quite long, so if you're ever worried about whether or not you want to spend this much money on it, considering game time, it's very much a good investment. You're definitely going to get your money's worth in gameplay hours. And that's not even counting the post-game. My friends are going to just see if you can mitigate some damage. Oh yeah, that's a good damage mitigation. Hey, that's a horn. Absolutely no defensive capabilities, but okay. So that's quite an angry FOE. This one actually is out of love. As you can tell with how red the icon is. I really do not know if we are strong enough to take it yet. Nothing ventured, nothing gained, let's go! It's the big boys. These are not fun. Now, let's see if we can actually do something. Remember, these are not weak to anything, so we're just going to hope for the best. Oh, fuck. Nice! Armbind. So, Armbind not only prevents their most of the arm attacks that they do, it also lowers, so basically halves their, halves all of their physical damage. So, yeah, this basically is going very smoothly at this point. Find his head, that would be very much appreciated. Especially if you could do it like this turn. Ow. Maybe fire is your best shot still. Perfect. Nice, headbind.
headbind, at least in later games, increases the magic damage that you take. In this game, not so much, because magic resistance is, well, just a stat, really. Magic resistance is more or less a stat rather than tied to a stat. Basically, the better defense you have, the more magic resistance you have, so... And now we want extra TP. And you can level up your defender a little bit. Yep. There we go. So yeah, that was the first FOE that we beat. Normally it is the other kind of FOE on this floor, but for now this will do. And that's a buff code. Very, very nice. There. We can have some extra defense. Oh boy. Still not right. Ow. Actually, you go deal with that. Way too much healing for the little hit points that he had. But I would rather do that than use the amount of TP that Clarissa still has, because Clarissa can be used to heal the entire party. And as you can tell, level 7, we're just mopping the floor with basically everything in here. I'm not going to say that to defenders, of course, but hey. That's the stairs. Down. Marble or card of soldiers. Beasts of red tooth and claw run rampant here. Yeah, they're not kidding. They are not kidding at all. Like that dot right there, that is something we are not going to mess with. I think I completely messed up. There, like that. Because that thing over there, that is something that will kill you dead. Luckily, it is also not the brightest, so we can just walk past it. And we have this weird root thing. Which is weak against, as you might expect, cuts and fire. And also the special fire. Thank you, Tulio. this one takes 2 steps for every 30 steps that you take, so... Or 3 for every 4. In any case, it walks a bit, bit in a staggered pattern. This is something they should definitely have sped up as well, the debuff animation. The buffer of debuff animations. That guy takes 3 steps for every 4 you take. So now I can do this. Three and four. 1, 2, 3. And we pass him. And this goes over like that. Now, I am not going to color in all of that because of the thing I said before. You have to actually step near on each of the squares in order to actually see FOEs. So I'm just gonna do that. I'm not gonna color, that's basically the way that I operate in any of these games, even the newer ones where you do see FOEs from like a mile away once they even behind walls and stuff. I just don't use it. You can do that. Okay, so it's not a head skill. Fuck. I do believe that there is a passage around here somewhere, but that's mainly to get back to this area. It is a two-way passage, it's just not something we can access from this side. I definitely am going to have to put that on the cursor keys and just use the control stick to move around. Now this is pretty much the only actual FOE puzzle that this game has. Oh, this is not good. We're gonna try and get out. Because I do not want to win this and I hope no one dies. Thank you. This is indeed a perfect spot to go and call it an episode after we go through this little thing. Ren and Tlaka. Everybody has like a weird different name, different way to pronounce the Hexer's name, but I call it Tlaka. So yeah, basically another official mission-ish thingy. And so with that, I am just going to teleport back home and do some final preparations for the next run. And then I'm gonna call this video here. Money. Anything else? Pyroxene. Oh, this is an interesting one, but we'll see that next time. So. I would say thank you for watching these 2 hours already of this game. And perhaps we'll I'll see whether or not I continue this. I definitely do want to play through this entire game, but I don't know if I'll play through all of it on screen. So, once again, thank you for watching, and maybe I'll see you guys some other time.